Good morning. How are you all? I'm the auntie is back again. I hope you all are taking care of yourself and keeping yourself safe and healthy, right? Today is the time to start coloring our Wali art drawing that we did last week. So the thing that I wanted to tell you about the colors was these people used all the earthy colors like ochre, that mud brown color, red, black, and they used indigo also, and the henna, mehndi color. So these were the colors that they used, white color they used, and it was made out of the paste of rice. Occasionally there was some yellow and all, which they made out of turmeric, haldi. Yes, see how creative these people were, and limitations they had, still they made so many colors with these limitations around them. And the beautiful results you can see of the Wali art, because it was made generally on the wall, the sides of the door and all. So they used a bamboo stick, which they chewed towards the end to make it look as flexible and work as flexible as a paintbrush. So today I am also using these earthy colors only, but it is your choice. If you want, you can make it colorful. You can use greens and other blue shades and all if you want, but I'll be coloring with the earthy colors. So let's start the coloring, right?
Okay, so here we are. Last week, you remember, we did this drawing and I have already outlined, because you people also know how to do the outlining. So small things with the gel pen or the CD marker like this, and big things with the sketch pen. Please don't forget to use a scale. And you remember I taught you stripe art in class 3. How did we use the scale while using a sketch pen? We always kept the scale upside down like this, right? So that the sketch pen ink doesn't spread. Okay. Now as for the colors, I told you the colors that the Wali artist used were all the earthy colors. So I'll make a combination of that only. It is up to you. If you want to make it colorful, you can do that, right? So now I have picked my colors. These two colors I'm taking for my border, and this I'm taking for my base, because I have decided to keep the figures white, right? So let's start the coloring. So as I told you, I have taken red and black for the border. Coloring, you all know, there is nothing new that I'm going to teach you about coloring. Just be careful about the strokes and the neatness. So this whole side I am going to do red. Okay, here this is all red. If you don't have crayons, you can use your color pencils as well, right? Now you can see that red part I have almost done, right? And black also I have started. So these triangles I am doing black, and I'm leaving the center line there. I am not filling any color. So here I'll first complete the whole black coloring. Okay, I am coloring it in the traditional way that they used to color in. You want to make it multicolored, you can do that. It is your choice, but don't put too many colors as the picture looks very bad. Okay. So now I'm done with the red and black. Now here in these center lines, these ones, I'm going to add a little yellow so that it brightens up a bit, because they used colors made up of turmeric, right? So with the sketch pen only, I am making lines. If you want, you can fill a color here, but I'll prefer to make lines with the sketch pen. And if you are not able to draw freehand, then please use a scale. So this way I'm going to fill the whole area. I'll start from the center so that this line becomes straight, and then right, straight, right here. Okay, so I have finished making my yellow lines. Now this area is left, so I'm thinking of adding yellow here in this leaf kind of a pattern so that it becomes a little broad. So this way I'm going to color all the four corner this leaf pattern here, right? This way.
Now after coloring these four corners, I will pick my CD marker or the gel pen that you have, and I'm going to make black lines here to fill up this white space like this. You can add a color also if you don't want to make lines. Your choice entirely. Fine. So now this is the end result after coloring the border. Now comes the center part. So like I told you in the beginning, I leave my figures white and the background I'm going to color. So I had taken these two colors. Remember, I'll do the background with these two colors. So what I'll do, I'll start with the yellow ochre color here around the figures. So this base I'm going to start with the ochre color first. Now this is the way I have done this ochre color. Now I'm going to add brown to this. So if you want, you can add just one color, you can mix two colors. It is up to you that how do you want to give the base. I am mixing brown here, and it can be in this outward direction also. This, instead of doing flat color, you can give it this style of coloring like you did in crazy circles in class 3, remember? So this way you can color. What I'll do is I'll make the bun, the hair part, black. Fine. This I'm not going to leave white. Now again, it is up to you. If you want to color the figures black, you can do that also. I am doing it white. If you want, you can do them black. Here in the instrument also, I'll add a little black so that they are visible, right? So this part which is left with the without the, that is without the lines, here I am going to add black. Okay, so here we are. Now I did the base like this. If you want, you can make it straight, right? So you can make them absolutely straight in one single color. I have used lines in the diagonal almost, diagonal direction here, and you can just keep them straight. It is up to you. Now I did this black, I colored this red. Your choice entirely, whichever colors you want, you can use. Okay,
so we are done with the coloring. I hope you like the results. Now your choice, whichever colors you want, you can use. And just nice proper coloring in proper directions. Use of scale, don't forget sketch pen, gel pen, CD marker, whatever you have. So this brings to the end of our first topic, that is Warli Art. Children, I tried my level best to teach you as much as I can with the help of videos. And I hope you people enjoyed and you were able to learn. So you finish this drawing of yours, and I hope that the school opens soon so that I can see your work. Till then, take good care of yourself, do your work, finish it, don't leave it halfway. Okay, and hoping to meet you all soon. Take care. Bye.